to SRA 221. During this lecture, we will be discussing security fundamentals. Some topics that we will be discussing is why is security important? We will also go over the important security requirements, as well as provide some examples of threats and vulnerabilities. In today's society, information systems are prevalent throughout our day-to-day activities. The types of devices that we use in our daily lives for personal and business has exploded in growth over the past couple of years. Now, just about every business heavily depends on computer networking. Businesses utilize networking to build strong relationships with customers as well as their partners and improve overall efficiencies in day-to-day business activities. The explosive growth in the industry has caused a large number of vulnerabilities and security incidents amongst many large businesses. Business information systems infrastructures are very complex, causing many of the problems faced today. But the majority of the problems are related to individual social vulnerabilities and threats. In today's technologically advanced world, we are starting to store more and more personal information on the web and on servers. This information can be easily gathered by malicious users wanting to exploit that data unbeknownst to the end user. Businesses rely on users utilizing their services to store their information on their platforms, leading to globalization of their networks. The global reach of businesses often puts additional vulnerabilities on their infrastructure from both the inside and outside of the business. A simple search on the web for security vulnerabilities will yield many results. The number of incidents and vulnerabilities increase as technologies evolve and new devices are present and utilized in our day-to-day lives. Many ask, why are today's networks so vulnerable? The infrastructure itself is becoming more complex, which is leading to more holes to exploit in the systems utilized by end users and businesses. Additionally, hacking tools of many varieties are available freely to any users on the web. In regards to social vulnerabilities, users and system administrators generally have a poor understanding of security itself. As we discussed earlier, more and more users are using the internet now. In businesses, all employees are generally trained to mitigate vulnerabilities, but many training methods have shown to be ineffective. One of the most common problems is using the same username and password with accounts. Businesses often think of security as an add-on requirement. Security and information systems infrastructures are very costly, and businesses are usually concerned about the cost of security itself. Thus, they do not invest as much as they should into risk mitigation. The internet is considered a double-edged sword. Most individuals use it in their day-to-day lives and have become heavily dependent on it. The internet makes your life easier and more enjoyable, but also leaves a lot of personal information readily available to hackers. The NIST Computer Security Handbook defines the term computer security as shown above. The definition introduces three key objectives that are at the heart of computer security: integrity, availability, and confidentiality. Confidentiality refers to preventing the disclosure of information to unauthorized individuals and systems. For example, a credit card transaction on the internet requires a credit card number to be transmitted from the buyer to the server and from the server to a transaction processing network. While doing this, the system attempts to enforce confidentiality by encrypting the card number using transmission protocols. It also will attempt to limit the places where the transmission ends up. Integrity means that the data is consistent over its whole life cycle. It means that the data cannot be modified in an unauthorized or undetected manner. Lastly, we have availability, which means that information data should be available to authorized users upon request. While these are just basic concepts, nowadays they are considered almost not enough to design the complex security requirements that modern internet and information systems require. Additional requirements that you might see in the textbook will be adaptation, authenticity, and accountability. In this discussion, we will only focus on the three basic concepts of integrity, availability, and confidentiality. Before this class, you probably have heard the term cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is a new way of defining computer systems that are connected into one another networking formats. It is difficult to define security in the context of the cyber world. Therefore, there is no formal definition for cybersecurity. This class will enable you to think of the definition of cybersecurity in your own context. Additionally, you will analyze how we can actually measure cybersecurity. Think about things like which computer is actually more secure and in what type of environment. Moreover, think about operating systems and their various security measures as well. Here you will see the CIA triad. As I mentioned before, the CIA triad is focused on the basics of confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Although the use of the CIA triad to define security objectives is well established, some people in the security field feel that it needs additional concepts to present a complete picture. Two of the most commonly mentioned are authenticity and accountability. Authenticity. The property of being genuine and being able to be verified and trusted. Confidence in the validity of a transmission, a message, or message originator. The second concept, accountability, is a security goal that generates the requirement for actions of an entity to be traced uniquely to that entity. Data and services have many threats and vulnerabilities and are prone to attacks if the CIA triad is not sufficiently managed. System resources could become corrupted, causing a loss of integrity. They can become leaky, causing a loss of confidentiality. And they can also become unavailable, causing a loss of availability. Attacks are threats carried out and may be passive, active, insider, and outsider attacks. RFC 2828 describes four kinds of threat consequences and kinds of attacks that results in unauthorized disclosure of information, leading to a threat to the confidentiality of the data. Deception, which is a threat to system and data integrity. Disruption, causing a threat to system availability and system integrity. And lastly, usurpation, which is the misuse of systems, leading to a threat of system integrity. So how can attacks be carried out? In general, we can say that attacks are either passive or active. A passive attack is an attack that does not alter communication. This type of attack is usually conducted by using sniffing packets, where the attacker gathers information. This type of attack can include skinning for open ports and vulnerabilities. The sole purpose of this type of attack is just to gain information about the target, and again, no data is changed when the packets are being transmitted. An active attack is when an attacker attempts to make changes to the data transmission from the target. The attacker can modify packet transmissions to pretend to be a user of a system to gain access or to gain greater privileges than they are authorized for. With many sources of cyber threats prevalent in today's era, we must know some countermeasures to protect ourselves. A countermeasure is any means taken to deal with a security attack. Ideally, a countermeasure can be devised to prevent a particular type of attack from succeeding. When prevention is not possible or fails in some instance, the goal is to detect the attack and then recover from the effects of the attack. A countermeasure may itself introduce new vulnerabilities. Moreover, residual vulnerabilities may remain after the imposition of countermeasures. Such vulnerabilities may be exploited by threat agents representing a residual level of risk to the assets. Owners will seek to minimize that risk, given other constraints.